Hello everyone, today we are going to do chapter number 2, real numbers, practice set number 2.2 we are going to complete today. So let's start with the first question. Show that 4 root 2 is an irrational number. So for that the solution is going to be, let us suppose that 4 root 2 is a rational number. So this you all have to suppose, assume. Alright, so therefore 4 root 2 is equal to A upon B, where B is not equal to 0. Alright children, so when you suppose 4 root 2 is a rational number, that means A upon B, where B is not equal to 0. A, B are the integers. Okay, so this you all have to define after writing this statement. So therefore root 2 is equal to A upon 4b. This 4 is going to change its place. Okay, so it will be 4 upon b. Let's keep this as the first equation. Now therefore A upon 4b is a rational number because integers are rational numbers, isn't it? Both the integers, that is A and B, are, we have already written, isn't it? So because integers are rational numbers. Alright, so over here what we have done is, we have just taken a statement, we have defined what we have written in the statement, and according to the property of the irrational numbers, we have written that A upon 4b is integers are natural. So on the right hand side, you will see that is, this is the right hand side, isn't it, of this equation. Right hand side is the rational number, whereas on the left hand side is an irrational number. Root 2 is an irrational number. This is contradictory. So therefore our supposition, we have supposed, isn't it? So our supposition that 4 root 2 is a rational number is wrong. So we have supposed this, isn't it? Children, you all have to understand this. Everything you all have to write it on your own. There is nothing much specified over here. This can change according to the teacher also. Now, what we have assumed? We have assumed this as a rational number. Okay, now for rational number over here, there is an irrational number, whereas on the right hand side, it's a rational number. Irrational and rational numbers. So this is opposite, isn't it? The supposition that we have taken is wrong. That is why it is wrong that it is a rational number. Therefore, 4 root 2 is an irrational number. It's very easy to define. Okay, we have to just use the properties of irrational numbers and write it in this way. Now, let's move on to the next question. Prove that 3 plus root 5 is an irrational number. Okay, irrational number again we have to prove. So same steps I will repeat. Let us suppose, if you all practice it once or twice, I am sure you will get it, because nothing much is to be explained over here in this question. These are the properties of rational and irrational numbers. Rational numbers. Therefore, 3 plus root 5 is equal to A upon B. B is not equal to 0. Okay. And A, B are integers. Okay. So you will see same sentence we have written above in the first question also. Same we have taken, only the question has changed. Now, over here, root 5 will remain as it is. Okay. And A upon B, this plus will change to minus 3. Let's keep this as first equation. Okay, now you will compare the left hand side and the right hand side. Now, the right hand side, you will see it's a rational number. Okay, this is the right hand side. So you will see that it's a rational number to the left hand side, root 5 is an irrational number. Okay, again this is opposite. Okay, so this is irrational number, rational number. So they are not rational numbers that we have supposed. Again the same question, are supposition that 3 plus root 5 is an rational number is wrong. Why it is wrong? Because at the left hand side irrational number and at the right hand side it's a rational number. That sentence you all can write it, if you, even if you all skip it, no problem. You all can write it in this way also and conclude it. Therefore, 3 plus root 5 is an irrational number. Next question is, represent the number root 5 and root 10 on a number line. Now for this we have to draw a number line, children. First we will write the measurements. Okay, take line L. Okay, then OP on that line will be 2 units and PQ, which will be perpendicular to the line L, will be 1 unit. Okay, so these are the measurements that you all have to take. Now, how are you going to draw a number line? For that, draw a number line. This question, we have done it last year also, children. So, in the same way, we have to complete this question. Okay, so what we have taken? We have taken line L. Now, we are taking OP, which is supposed to be 2 unit. Means the distance between the two numbers has to be how much? 2 units. Alright, so this is going to be 2 units. Okay, I hope it is clear, the points are clear. Okay, now let's take this as 0, minus 1, minus 2, 1, 2 and 3. Okay, now what we have taken? We have taken 2 units, isn't it? OP is supposed to be 2 units, means O is going to be over here, P is going to be over here. Now from the point P, draw a perpendicular line. Okay, that is 90 degree wala line. So this is going to be your 90 degree. Extend it a little bit. Alright, now what you all have to do? You all have to take OP, which is 1 unit. Now this is 2 units, isn't it? That means this is going to be your 1 unit. Okay, take this 1 unit. Keep it over here, draw an arc. Okay, so once you have drawn an arc, you will get this point as Q. Okay, now join this arc point and this O point. Okay, so that you will get a triangle which is of 90 degree. Now we need to mark root 5. So how are you going to mark root 5 over here? For that you have to take a distance of this. Alright, then draw an arc. Got it, children? Now this point is supposed to be your root 5. Okay, we will name it as R. This is supposed to be P. Got it? It's very easy to draw. Same thing we have done last year also. Now we have to mark root 10 also. So root 10 we will mark it on 3. For that, again 90 degree angle, perpendicular is to be drawn. Okay, this perpendicular we have taken, same pattern you all have to follow. So from this 1 unit distance you all have to take and draw. Okay, so 1 unit. Okay, keep it over here, mark the point. Okay, we will mark this as T. Any other alphabet you all can mark, no problem. Then join this point with 0 or O. Got it? Now what you all have to draw? You all have to draw an arc. For that, consider these two points. Okay, you need not draw a different number line, children. You all can use this number line to draw innumerable roots. You all can show on the same number line. Okay, so this point is supposed to be as U. We will take this as M. This point as M, this point as U, which is supposed to be root 10. Got it, children? In this way, you all have to mark everything. This is 1 centimeter, 1 unit. Okay, this line is 1 unit, this line is 1 unit, this is 2 units. So, this is supposed to be root 5 and this is supposed to be root 10. Isn't it easy? Now, by Pythagoras theorem, you all have to show this drawing is to be shown in the written form, that is in right angled triangle OPQ by PT theorem or Pythagoras theorem, one and the same. OQ square is equal to OP square plus PQ square, which is 2 square plus 1 square, which is supposed to be 4 plus 1, that is 5. So OQ square, OQ not square, is going to be root 5. Okay, so in this way you all have to write. Now for the other line also, that is OR. Okay, now O and R that we have marked, it is root 5 on the number line. Now the coordinates of the point R is root 5. In this way we have to show it for root 10 also. Okay, similarly we have to show it for root 10. So therefore in right angled triangle, that is OTM, OTM. Okay, so OT square is equal to OM square plus MT square. By PT theorem we have got OM is how much? O and M is 3. So 3 square plus 1 square. So this is going to be 3 square, 9 plus 1. OT square is going to be 10. Therefore, OT is supposed to be root of 10. Got it, children? In this way, you all have to draw the number line and mark the rational irrational numbers. Now, question number 3 is, write any 3 rational numbers between the 2 numbers given below. So, the 2 numbers that they have given is 0.3 and minus 0.5. You all have to write the rational numbers between these 2 numbers. Okay, so how are you going to write these? This is the solution. Half. We will take the same steps, only the numbers are going to change, children. So, remember the steps. That's it. Okay, so this is going to be half 0.3 plus and minus will change to minus 0.5. So it is going to be half, subtract this, it's going to be minus 0.2. It's very easy to subtract, children. So the answer is minus 0.1. Okay, so this is your first step. Now use this number and subtract it with this. Okay, so again same step, half, but the numbers are going to change. This with this you all have to take in this first step. So it is going to be minus 0.1, okay, plus 0.3. Got it, children? In this way you all have to find the numbers between these numbers. So minus, when you do it, it is going to be 0.2. Now how are you going to minus this, children? It's very easy. 0.3 and 0 minus 1. So 2 is going to come, plus and minus minus. So sign of the bigger number, that is plus. So it is going to be plus 0.2. I hope this is clear to everyone. And then when you divide it, see 2 ones are 2 ones are. So the answer is going to be 0.1. Okay, so 1 is minus 1, here plus 1. Now, third we will find, we have to find it in 3 steps. The third part is going to be using minus this number with this number. Okay, first is to be subtract added with both the numbers. So it is going to be minus 0.1 and plus minus 0.5. So you all have to use only the numbers that have been given in the question. It's very easy to solve, children. 0.1 minus plus and minus. Minus, that is 0.5. Added, minus and minus is going to be plus, that is why. And sign of the bigger number, that is minus 0.6. 2 ones are, 2 threes are. So therefore 1 upon 2 will get cancelled. 2 ones are, 2 threes are. So the answer is going to be minus 0.3. Okay, so these are the three numbers that we have got. So therefore, write it down: minus 0.3, minus 0.1, and 0.1 are the three rational numbers. Okay, in this way you all have to find, children. It's very easy to solve. Next question: minus 2.3. So this is going to change to minus 2.300, and the next one is minus 2.33. So this will change to minus 2.330. Okay, now why we have taken zeros over here, children? Because you will see this is small number, this is also small numbers, to equalize this. Now you will see over here there are three digits, over here also there are three digits. Okay, so in this form you all have to form three digits. Okay, now first half minus 2 point, this number we will take, plus then this number 2.330, same step as we did. Now over here this is going to change to half minus 2.300 plus and minus, minus 2.330. Okay, don't get confused with the numbers, do it very slowly, subtract it. Okay, plus and minus, minus, so it's, sorry, minus and minus plus, it's going to be added, not subtracted. You all have to add it in the rough column. It is very easy to add. 2 plus 2, 4, minus 3 plus 3, 6, 3 as it is 0. Okay, orally also you all can do it. So when you subtract it, 2 1s are, 2 2s are, 2 3s are, 3, 2 1s are, 2 5s are. So the answer is going to be minus 2.315. Okay, now how I got this, I will do it over here and show, because many of you all are not going to get it. So 2 1s are, 2 2s are, 0.2 3s are, again 2 1s are, 2 5s are, 10. Got it, children? So 2.315, that is the answer. This you all have to add with this and then with this. Okay, so first half minus 2.315 plus minus 2.300. I have taken the first number, that is this number, okay, which is going to be half minus 2.315 minus, minus will only come, 2.300. So again half, add it, 4.615. okay, now subtract it, children. Very easy to divide it, as I showed you over here. In the same way you all have to divide it, 3075. Okay, the next pattern I will do it over here, that is half. Now same number you all have to subtract it with this number, that is minus 2.315 plus minus 2.330, half minus 2.315 minus 2.330. So half, add it, minus 41645, divide it, the answer is going to be minus 2.325. So these are the three numbers, children, between the rational numbers, that is minus 2.3075 minus 2.315 minus 2.3225 are the three rational numbers.